Dear students, welcome to Mathematics Online classes. In the last class, we have studied area under simple curves. Now, we are going to study area of the region bounded by a line and a curve. Concept is same, there is no extra concept here. Directly, we will take the problem. Example 3 is written here. Find the area of the region bounded by the curve y is equal to x square and the line y is equal to 4. Let us draw the graph of this curve and a line. See, y is equal to x square. It is a parabola symmetric with respect to yx. Means parabola is of the shape x square is equal to 4ay type here. So, curve will be symmetric with respect to the y axis. This is what? This is y is equal to x square. And the line y is equal to 4. Y is equal to 4 is a line parallel to x axis and passing through the point 0,4. 0,4 will be somewhere here. So, this is the line y is equal to 4. I have to find out this area. See, area you can consider in two ways. One way is considering the vertical strips, another way is considering the horizontal strips. Let us consider vertical strips first. I will solve in both the ways here. I will consider vertical strips. See, both side on the left hand side and right hand side curve is symmetric with respect to the y axis. Hence, we can take out finding the area only in the first quadrant and we can multiply with the here. Now, I am considering area only in first quadrant, first by considering the vertical strips. Okay, vertical strips in the sense, if this is the strip, now I will extend it like this here. This is what? This is very small area, dx. Now, then here, from where to where I have to integrate, area is starting from here, that is from the y-axis. So, this is x is equal to 0 line. And where the area is getting end? Area is getting end at the point of intersection of the line y is equal to 4 and the curve y is equal to x square. What is the point of intersection of y is equal to the x square and y is equal to 4? That is, to solve y is equal to x square and y is equal to 4. That point will be the point of intersection. So, y is equal to 4 is there, means you substitute here. This is 4 is equal to x square. 4 can be written as plus or minus 2 whole square, which is equal to x square. Then x is equal to plus or minus 2. X is equal to 2 is there, you know. X is equal to 2 is the line here. We should write it properly. X is equal to 2, straight line we should draw. X is equal to 2 here. And what about the x is equal to minus 2? X is equal to minus 2 is on the left hand side. We don't want that. We need to integrate from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 2. See here, this area is not bounded by the single curve. If you integrate on the line x is equal to 4, what it gives us? It gives us the complete area from the curve up to x axis and in between the lines x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2. We don't want that. See here, area is equal to 2 times left hand side, right hand side, same thing is there. What we do, we will integrate along this line first, that is y is equal to 4, y into dx is there. Integrating from 0 to 2, y into dx. This is like upper curve, and now, but while integrating from y is equal to 4 line, on the line y is equal to 4, what it gives us? It includes whole area. This unshaded area is also included in this. I told you, if you integrate on the curve, it gives us area below the curve, above the x-axis and in between the lines. As this unshaded area is also included, we need to delete this unshaded area. So, to delete that unshaded area, to remove that part, what we do? This unshaded area, you see, this unshaded area is bounded by the curve y is equal to x square, y axis, and in between the lines x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2. So, here we subtract the area bounded by the curve. That means 0 to 2 again, 0 to 2 y into dx again. See,
Very easily we can remember this kind of problems as area is equal to 2 times integrating from 0 to 2. Integrating from 0 to 2 it is fixed. You can take here like upper curve minus lower curve. Upper curve minus lower curve like that we can take. Upper curve is, you see, upper curve is y is equal to 4, that line, and lower curve is parabola y is equal to x square. Yes, first here this is 4 into dx minus of 0 to 2, y is what, this is the curve, y is equal to x square. Area bounded by this parabola, this is the white area, means unshaded area, we are deleting, it gives us only the shaded area. Area is equal to 2 times integration of 4 is what, 4 will be constant, integration of 1 with respect to x is x, so it can be written as 4x integrating from 0 to 2 minus of integration of x square with respect to x from 0 to 2, integration of x square is x cube by 3 integrating from 0 to 2, 2 times 4 into what is this, 2 minus 0 minus of, here it is 2 cube means 8, 8 by 3 minus 0 by 3 is 0, 2 into 4 into 2 is 8 minus of 8 by 3, 2 into here 8 3 is 24, 24 minus 8 by 3, 24 minus 8 is 16, 16 by 3 into 2 is there, this is nothing but 32 by 3 square units. Area bounded by the line y is equal to 4, the curve y is equal to x square, and the lines x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 2 is 32 by 3 square units. See, this problem we solved by considering vertical strips. Can we solve by considering the horizontal strips? Yes, we can solve it. Both the methods it is better to know, but most of the problems are solved by considering vertical strips only. Same problem I will solve with the horizontal strips. Okay, let us draw the graph of y is equal to x square and y is equal to 4. This is y axis and this is x axis. Y is equal to x square curve it is, and the line y is equal to 4 will be like this, y is equal to 4. Here, instead of considering the vertical strips, we are considering horizontal strips. So, no need to write all this, just I am showing you which area we are calculating. Here what comes, dy comes, means what is our area, area A is equal to integration of x with respect to y here. Okay, now here you see it is like area under simple curve only if we consider horizontal strips. How it is area under simple curve, sir? See, if you integrate from x axis to the line y is equal to 4, it will be like area under simple curves. Yes, we are starting the area from the x axis. X axis means this is the, its equation is y is equal to 0. We are integrating from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to 4 along the line y is equal to x square. It should be taken like x is equal to g of y. Y is equal to x square, this is nothing but x square is equal to y, this is x is equal to root y. So 2 times we have to take area, 2 times integrating from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to 4 line, lower limit is 4, upper limit is 4, x into dy, 2 times integrating from 0 to 4, what is x, x is root y, square root of y into dy, 2 into what is square root of y? Square root of y is y to the power of 1 by 2. Like that we can write, so that we can integrate it easily. 2 times. What is integration of y raised to 1 by 2? We will use the form x raised to n with respect to x. Here it is y raised to n with respect to y. Its integration is y raised to 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1. from 0 to 4. Two times. Now, let us substitute the upper limit. 4 to the power of 1 by 2 plus 1 is 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 minus of 0. Now, area A is equal to 2 into 4 to the power of 3 by 2. 4 can be written as 2 square whole to the power of 3 by 2, which is multiplied with by 3 by 2 becomes into 2 by 3. Here, square root get cancelled. 2 into 2 cube into 2 by 3. 2 cube means 8. 8 into 2, 16. 16 into 2, 32. 32 by 3 square units is the area bounded by the line and the curve y is equal to x square. This is how solving the problems by considering horizontal strips. Okay, this is about example 3. Now we will move on to the next example. Now, let us take example 4. Example 4 is, find the area of the region, find the area of the region in the first quadrant, enclosed by the x-axis, comma the line y is equal to x and the circle x square plus y square is equal to 32. Okay, this area we are going to find now. Let us draw the graph. Find the area of the region in the first quadrant. Okay, we need to find out only in the first quadrant. No need to find the area which is there in remaining quadrants. Okay, enclosed by x-axis. Yes, x-axis is included. The line y is equal to x. How will be the line y is equal to x? Y is equal to x. X is equal to 0, y equal to 0, 0.0, 0. X is equal to 1, y is equal to 1, 0.1, 1. X is equal to 2, y is equal to 2, 0.2, 2. This is a linear equation. It will be a straight line. So this is what? This is y is equal to x line. And the circle. Circle is x square plus y square is equal to 32. I want to write it in the form x square plus y square is equal to r square. See, 32 can be written as square root of 32 whole square. What is square root of 32? 16 into 2 I can write. 16 is perfect square of 4. 4 into root 2 we will write. 4 into root 2 whole square. So, x square plus y square is equal to 4 into root 2 whole square. See, this is a circle with center 0, 0 and radius 4 into root 2. So here, considering origin as the center, that is 0, 0, and 4 into root 2 as the radius, draw a circle here. Okay, let us draw the circle here. This is how. What about this point? This is 0, 0, y-axis it is, its equation is x is equal to 0. How much is this length? This length is nothing but radius. This is 4 into root 2. This point will be 4 into root 2 comma 0. If we draw a line here which is parallel to the y-axis and passing through the point 4 into root 2 comma 0, this will be x is equal to 4 into root 2. Okay. Now what we need to find out here? Read the question once again. Find the area in the first quadrant. Okay. Only in the first quadrant. Enclosed by x-axis. X-axis should be included. The line y is equal to x. Yes, line y is equal to x, x-axis, and the circle. Circle is here. Means which area? This area I have to find out. This area I have to find out. Now you see, is this area bounded by the single curve? No, it is not bounded by the single curve. You see, up to this point of intersection of the line y is equal to x and the circle, it is bounded by the line y is equal to x. And from this line, from this point onwards, next it is bounded by circle. So let us, from the point of intersection, I am drawing one more horizontal line, the which is horizontal to the y axis. What is this point of intersection? So what is this point will be, what is the line equation? So this point will be point of intersection of y is equal to x and the circle. So now here to solve y is equal to x and x square plus y square is equal to 32. We are going to solve this. Let us substitute y is equal to x in the circle equation. This become x square plus x square is equal to 32, 2x square is equal to 32, x square is equal to 32 by 2, 2 1s are 2, 16s are, x square is equal to 16 can be written as plus or minus 4 whole square. Means here x is equal to plus or minus 4. Here this point is 4 comma something. 4 comma something means 4 comma x is equal to 4, y is equal to, if you substitute in the line equation or a circle equation, we will get 4 here again. That 4 comma 4, y coordinate we don't want. This is 4 comma something means this point will be 4 comma 0. As this point is 4 comma 0, line is parallel to the y axis and passing through the point 4 comma 0. Its equation can be written as x is equal to 4. Okay, here is x is equal to 4, this is x is equal to 0. What we do here, to find out this area, area A is equal to, first of all we will integrate from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to 4, 0 to 4, along which line, means along which one, along y is equal to x, this first area we are finding here. Okay, why we are splitting it? Because it is not bounded by single curve. Here up to this it is bounded by line, from here it is bounded by circle. 0 to 4, you see, 0 to 4 it is bounded by the line. Let us take this as y1 and this as, this is a circle, you know, let me take it as y is equal to f of x. How will you take? See, this is x square plus y square is equal to 4 into root 2 whole square. Now it is y square is equal to 4 into root 2 whole square minus x square. Then y is equal to square root of 4 into root 2 whole square minus x square. Yes. Now, bounded by the line. Let us take that y1 and this as a y2. This is y1 into dx, vertical strips only we are considering, and we have to take plus here, total area we want, you know, this area plus this area, plus of next, from where to where I have to integrate, from the line x is equal to 4 to x is equal to 4 into root 2. So 4 is lower limit, 4 into root 2 is upper limit, along which line, that is second curve, y2 into dx I will write. Okay, substituting y1 and y2 here, this is area A is equal to, integrating from 0 to 4, y1 is nothing but this one line, that is x into dx, plus integrating from 4 to 4 into root 2, y2 is what? Y2 is this circle. Circle equation, it is written square root of 4 into root 2 whole square minus of x square into dx. Now can we integrate it? Yes, very easily we can integrate. Integration of x, it is direct x square by 2. What about the second integral? For second integral, we will use a standard form using integration of square root of a square minus x square. It is in this form. This is x by 2 into square root of a square minus x square plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a plus c. Okay, now area is equal to, what is integration of x? X square by 2 from 0 to 4 plus of, next, this is here in place of a, 4 into root 2 is there, x by 2 into square root of whatever is there, that is 4 into root 2 whole square minus x square plus of a square by 2, that is 4 into root 2 whole square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a. X by a is 4 into root, okay, from 4 to 4 into root 2. This is, now substituting the upper limit and lower limit, upper limit 4 square by 2 minus of 0, this is over, plus of, next here substituting the upper limit 4 into root 2, 4 into root 2 by 2 into square root of 4 into root 2 whole square minus 4 into root 2 whole square, that become 0. 0 plus of 4 into root 2 whole square, it is nothing but 32. We did that. 32 we are written as 4 into root 2 whole square, means that is 32. 32 by 2 into sine inverse of 4 into root 2 by 4 into root 2, that is nothing but 1. This is substituting upper limit, minus of substituting the lower limit. Lower limit 4 we are substituting here. This become 4 by 2 into square root of 4 into root 2 whole square minus 4 square plus of, this is 4 into root 2 whole square by 2 means 32. 32 by 2 into sine inverse of 4 by 4 into root 2. 4 square by 2 is 16 by 2. 16 by 2 is 8. Let it be right. 8. Now, 0 gone. 32 by 2 means 16 into sine inverse of, these two get cancels out, sine inverse of 1. Sine inverse of 1 is 90 degree, pi by 2, minus of 4 by 2 is 2 into square root of 4 into root 2 whole square is what? 32. 32 minus 4 square is 32 minus 16. 32 minus 16 is 16. Plus of 32 by 2 is 16 into sine inverse of, you see, sine inverse of 4 by 4 into root 2. 4, 4 get cancelled, sine inverse of 1 by 2. Sorry, sine inverse of 1 by root 2. Sine inverse of 1 by root 2 is 45 degree, that is pi by 4. Okay, here 8 plus 2 ones are 2 8s are, this is 8 pi minus 2 into square root of 16 is 4. So plus of 4 ones are 4, 4s are plus 4 pi. Okay, this is 8 plus 8 pi. This minus will get multiplied to both the terms. Minus 2 into 4 means minus 8, plus into minus, minus 4 pi. Minus 8 plus 8 both get cancelled. 8 pi minus 4 pi means it is 4 pi square units. So area bounded by the line y is equal to x and the circle x square plus y square is equal to 32. And the x axis is 4 pi square units. Okay, now let us take one more example here. I will tell you how to solve this. Next example is, find the area of the ellipse. Example 5 we are solving. Find the area of the ellipse. Area of the ellipse. X square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, and the ordinates x is equal to 0 and x is equal to ae and x is equal to ae, where b square is equal to a square into 1 minus e square, e less than 1 and e less than 1. Okay, this area we are going to find. See, find the area of the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Ellipse it is. Here you can take here with this expression b square is equal to a square into 1 minus a square. We can come to know that major axis is along the x axis. Graph will be like this. Area of the ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Here I will write y is equal to in terms of x, because I want to go with the considering the vertical strips here. Okay, what is y is equal to? This is x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1. Simplifying this, we have take this x square by a square to the right hand side, y square by b square is equal to 1 minus of x square by a square, y square by b square is equal to a square minus x square by a square, y square is equal to b square by a square into a square minus x square. Taking square root on both sides, we have y is equal to b by a into square root of a square minus x square it is. This means this curve is y is equal to b by a into square root of a square minus x square. Now they asked you to find out area which is there between x is equal to 0 and x is equal to ae. X is equal to, what is that ae? Ae comma 0, that is focus coordinates, somewhere here it will be. X is equal to 0 means equation of y axis, x is equal to 0. Ordinates, x is equal to ae, this is the point ae comma 0, parallel to the y axis means line will be here, this is x is equal to ae. Which area we need to find out here? Ellipse and the ordinates, x is equal to plus ae, only this one I have to consider, left hand side I should not consider. Yes, this is what? This is what, and also the area which is below this also we need to find out, but we will take it as two times. Area is equal to here area is equal to integrating from 0 to ae, area is starting from 0 to ae, how many times? Two times I have to take, because same area is there below also. Along which line? Is it bounded by the single curve? Yes, it is bounded by the single curve y into dx, vertical strips we are considering y into dx. Area is equal to 2 times integrating from 0 to a. What is y? Y is b by a into square root of a square minus x square into dx. Now integration, area is equal to 2 times this b by a, constant multiple, write out of the integral 2b by a, integrating from 0 to a, square root of a square minus x square into dx. 2b by a as it is, integration of square root of a square minus x square, it is a standard result, write that standard result as x by 2 into square root of whatever is there plus a square by 2 into sine inverse of x by a. We know it, integrating from 0 to a e. Okay, 2b by a into, substitute the upper limit, a e by 2 into square root of a square minus of a e whole square means a square into e square, plus of a square by 2 into sine inverse of x is a e by a, minus of substituting the lower limit, it is 0 into anything 0, plus of a square by 2 into sine inverse of 0, sine inverse of 0 is also 0. Okay, 2b by a into a e by 2 into, here square root of a square is common, a square into 1 minus a square I can write, plus a square by 2 into a get cancel, we left with e there, this is sine inverse of a minus 0, leave that part. Now 2b by a into, here a by 2 into, a by 2 into square root of a square become a into root 1 minus a square, plus of a square by 2 into sine inverse of e. What is common from these two? Here a into a means a square. From these two, a square by 2 is common. Take it out. 2b by a into a square by 2 into e is there. E into square root of 1 minus a square plus a square by 2 is already outside. This is sine inverse of a. One time a get cancels, 2 also get cancels. This is ab into e into square root of 1 minus e square plus sine inverse of e is the area bounded by this ellipse and the ordinates x is equal to 0 and x is equal to a. Area, this is the final answer. Write the units, square units. Thank you.